It has stood the test of time. God's book, the Bible, still relevant in today's complex world. It is written, sharing messages of hope around the world.
The king had come. The Messiah had arrived. The angels visited, the shepherds came, and the wise men bore gifts. And now, as Mary held Jesus in her arms, she held the Creator, the Savior, and our King.
Hold on now, I gotta take a deep breath. I don't know what to say when I look in your eyes. You made the world before I was born, but here I am holding you in my arms tonight. No way. Could have left us on our own, but you're here. I don't know how long I'm gonna have you for, but I'll be watching when you change the world. Look at your hands, they're still so small. Someday you're gonna stretch them out and save us all. Noel, Noel, God with us, Immanuel. You're here, and I'm holding you so near. Oh, I'm staring into the face of my Savior, King and Creator. You could have left us on our own, but you're someday I'm gonna look back on this, the night that God became my baby boy. Someday you're gonna go home again, but you leave your spirit and flood the world with joy. You'll be
with his arrival, there was bound to be a change. He came to bring peace, yet turmoil abounded. He came to save and to heal, yet there were so many lost and diseased. in the midst of the restlessness of the day, amidst the problems of the day, the news of his birth spread. He lived his life to change the world, and now, as we sing and hear the songs and bells of Christmas, may our hearts be warmed by the peace that he brings.
I heard the bells on Christmas Day. Their old familiar carols play. And mild and sweet their songs repeat. Of peace on earth, goodwill to men.
Hi, my name is Ken Weeb, president of the Seventh-day Adventist Church in Alberta. On behalf of the 11,000 Seventh-day Adventist members in Alberta, I want to wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
Who is Jesus to me? Who is Jesus to you? all that happens in this world and all that goes on in this life today, there is one key to making sense of it all. One overarching subject that will get us through another day. It is the story of Jesus, the story of his birth, his life, and his death and sacrifice for us. You see, the story of Christmas is the story of Jesus, but it's your story as well. The coming of Jesus is good news because he came to save us. That is why Christmas time is so wonderful. It's all about the story of Jesus.
Tell me the story of Jesus. Write on my heart every word. Tell me the story.
Hi, my name is Wayne Colmore, president of the British Columbia Conference of Seventh-day Adventists. On behalf of our 11,000 members in British Columbia and the Yukon Territory, I want to wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
His birth led to his death. His death was voluntary. He laid down his life so we could live. The amazing statement of Romans 5:8 is this: but God demonstrates his own love toward us in that while we were still sinners, Christ died for us. While we were yet sinners. Friend, it doesn't matter where you are in life. Jesus came to bring to you real life and real happiness. His desire is that you would find peace in your heart with Him, that you would find peace in your life, even amidst the turmoil.
Let there be peace on earth, and let it begin with me.
My dear friends, amidst the tinsel, the trees, the gifts, the candy, and the baking, I hope that you find true and real peace today. The reason for this season is Jesus Christ and the story of Him coming to this planet to save us. His one desire is that He could be in a relationship with you. What holds you back today? Reach out. Grasp the hand of Jesus, the one who was born in a stable, slept in a manger, lived a life helping others, and paid the ultimate sacrifice, giving His life for you. He gave everything for you. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we thank You for Jesus. We thank You that He came to save us. Please help us to accept that gift today. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Friends, the holiday season is a special time where we can come together as families and eat together. And today I'm so happy to have both Darlene Blaney and Bev Edwards Haynes here in the kitchen with me. And they are going to demonstrate a couple of recipes to keep our holidays tasty but healthy. So ladies, what are we demonstrating today?
We're gonna start with a stuffed squash.
Okay, that sounds kind of interesting. So what are we gonna do to make a stuffed squash?
Well, first we gotta focus on our stuffing.
Okay.
So we're gonna actually begin with some fresh breadcrumbs.
There we go.
We just wanna take whatever loaf, whole grain bread, and put it in your food processor, and blend that all up into a nice, fine texture, and keep them fresh. You don't wanna toast these at all.
All right, now Bev, this is a whole grain bread. What kind of bread is this actually that we're using today?
I think this is the Silver Hills bread that we're using, and you know that's one of the lifestyle centers that we have in British Columbia.
Okay.
Yes.
And the Silver Hills bread is all whole grain bread, and one of the beauties of the Silver Hills bread is when you read the ingredients, it only takes you a couple of seconds because there are very few of them.
That's right.
So what else are we putting in the stuffing there, Darlene?
Okay, we're gonna add some grains. We're gonna add a couple of cups worth of your choice of grains. This can be kamut, it can be rice, it can be whatever grain you like. So we're gonna use some wild rice, and we're also gonna use some brown rice today.
All right, now what are some of the advantages, Darlene, of like wild rice? What is wild rice gonna do for you?
Well, basically, any of our grains in general are going to be high in fiber.
Okay.
That's probably the biggest key when it comes to whole grains. B vitamins, chromium. Chromium balances blood sugars. So not only does fiber balance, but also the chromium and the B vitamins.
Absolutely.
Excellent. Now
what
we want
we
to
next?
Add some color to this. So we're going to actually put in some onion and some celery, as well as some shredded carrot.
Okay.
Beautiful.
Yep.
I like onions and celery.
Good combination. Of course, the celery has wonderful sodium in there, natural sodium, and the carrots, vitamin A, and that shot of nice color there.
That's correct.
Perfect.
Now, lots of different textures going on here.
Absolutely.
Added to it, we're gonna add some dry roasted almonds, slivered almonds. So you wanna dry roast these just at a low temperature on your own in your oven at home. And then we're gonna add our seasonings. Now you can add a little bit of sea salt. We can sprinkle that kind of evenly over it there. And poultry seasoning. Now poultry seasoning does not have any poultry in it. It's just well known for stuffing poultry, our stuffing mixes.
So I know it's gonna have some of that sage in there and different things like that. That's gonna give it that real kind of stuffing flavor.
Very much so. And in fact, you can use sage if you prefer, just use half the amount.
Okay,
yep.
Very good.
And color, beautiful dried cranberries.
Cranberries.
And you can add fresh, you can use frozen, whatever you like.
Now ladies, what's the advantage of eating some cranberries?
Well, first of all, it's nice and sweet.
Okay.
It's like, a wonderful
like
treat.
Always like sweet.
Yeah. And again, high fiber.
Very good.
Very good. Yeah.
And then are we going to add anything else now?
We're going to add some water and a little bit of our olive oil as well, about a third of a cup of olive oil. So we can just go ahead and put
water
it on.
Already.
Sure, all over.
There
and then a little bit of our olive oil as well. And we just want to mix this up and then put it into a casserole dish, if you don't have one already, that you're mixing it in, and cover it and just bake it in the oven until it's nice and soft. You're mainly going by the vegetables being nice and tender.
Now, if someone wanted to make this a little lower fat, they didn't want to put the olive oil in, can they get away with doing that?
They can. You can just do a little bit more water.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right.
The oil just kind of gives a little bit different flavor, but also allows it to brown a little bit.
All right.
Yeah.
Now, so we put this in the oven.
We do.
And
bake it until soft.
Through the magic of television, we actually have a finished stuffing here. And what are we going to do with that stuffing after we've baked it in the oven? And how long are we going to bake it in the oven for?
It could take about 20 minutes.
Okay.
10 minutes, give it a stir, another 10 minutes. Just watch that it doesn't get too brown.
All right.
So the vegetables are, you just want a little crispness.
Now, ladies, I see that we do have a squash that we're about to stuff. What kind of squash do we have there, Bev?
Is this the spaghetti squash?
It is.
It certainly is. You know, we've been farming this past year. We've got all kinds of squash. I know my squash now, I tell ya.
Well, spaghetti is a very mild flavor as well. But you can use any kind of squash that you like. And we're just going to put in our stuffing.
Your butternut, your buttercup squash.
Absolutely.
Could even use a pumpkin if you wanted to,
absolutely.
I would imagine.
Yes, yes. If you want that brighter orange color, more vitamin A.
All right.
Interesting. This type of squash, not as much vitamin A, but has omega-3s in it, which is unique to this squash.
All right.
Yeah.
Now, you know, Bev, while Darlene is putting the stuffing in that squash, a lot of people say, oh, spaghetti squash tastes kind of plain. What are some things you can do with spaghetti squash to help it, other than stuff it, that make it maybe not so plain?
Right. Well, you know, one of my favorite ways is to just roast it with a little bit of olive oil and some garlic. We use a lot of garlic in my house. It's so good for you. And just that easy recipe right there, just roasted, wonderful.
All right. So, Darlene, we've got these stuffed.
Yes.
We're going to then take them and put them back in the oven.
Correct. I should mention you want to kind of bake your squash till it's pretty much done first, okay? And then, you know, put it here, put it in your stuffing. You can cover it if you wish, if you need to bake it a little bit more.
All right.
If it's pretty much baked, just warm it now in your oven. And heat that dressing up, garnish it, make it look beautiful.
That is wonderful. Ladies, this is looking delicious. If you want this recipe or other holiday recipes, including a special fresh cranberry sauce, go to www.itiswrittencanada.ca.
Hi, my name is Mark Johnson, president of the Seventh-day Adventist Church in Canada. On behalf of the 68,000 Seventh-day Adventists across our great nation, I want to wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
Dear friends, the Christmas season brings an end to the year. It is at this time that many people consider their end of the year giving to charitable organizations. It Is Written Canada is a not-for-profit charity that qualifies for tax-deductible giving. It Is Written Canada is committed to sharing a message of hope and wholeness through this program and a variety of humanitarian projects. If you would like to donate to this ministry as a part of your end of the year plan, you can call toll free. As a thank you for your tax deductible gift, we will send you the musical DVD, O Come All Ye Faithful, from my friends at Fountain View Academy. It will be a wonderful addition to your Christmas collection or even a good gift to give someone. My friends, thank you so much for watching. Please join us again next week. Until then, remember, it is written, man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeds from the mouth of God.